In this After Effects tutorial, I'll show you how to create a horror title animation. Hi guys, my name is Manuel. We'll set up the title combining a bunch of standard effects and a few simple expressions. And we'll make sure it's procedural. So stick around till the end. Alright, let's create a new comp. Name it title. And add a bit of text. All capitals, I use Futura PT Book, which is available on Adobe Fonts. Let's center the text, and let's use the alignment tool to center the layer. Awesome. Let's drag the comp down here onto the comp symbol and create a new comp, which we name title animation. First of all, we add a new solid. Color doesn't matter, and name it background. Move it to the bottom, then use the effects and presets window over here to add fill. Let's change this into a nice and, well, kind of bloody red. We add another solid on top of it and name it Turbulent Noise Background. Set the blending mode to overlay. You might have to switch the windows down here. Then we search for it and add Turbulent Noise. Fractal, basic. Noise type, soft linear. Contrast, 80. Brightness, around 30. We open transform and scale it up to 5000. Complexity, 6. Then we hold Option or Alt while clicking on the evolution stopwatch and add time, asterisk, 100 to the expression field, which will create a steady but very subtle background animation. Let's go back to the background solid and adjust the red though. Awesome. Now let's take care of the title. We add a fill effect to the title comp and change the color into a dark purple. Next, we add roughen edges. Set the edge type to spiky, order around 3, scale around 30, complexity 3. It's all threes. We duplicate the title comp and change some of the roughen edges settings. Order around 20, scale around 75, complexity 5. We only want this comp to blend through partly, so we need a Luma mat. We duplicate the turbulent noise layer, name it Turbulent Noise Title, and set the contrast to 415. Scale 100, complexity 10. And let's change the expression to time asterisk 300. We hide the layer, select the top comp layer, and add the set mat effect to it. We take the mat from our turbulent noise title layer, effects and masks, we use the luminance, and invert the mat. Better, but not there yet. We duplicate the title comp, delete roughen edges, and add Gaussian blur. Move it up, reset the blurriness to around 175. Awesome! This creates some nice bleeding details, but still way too clean. So we add another solid. Let's name it Turbulent Noise, and add, once again, Turbulent Noise. Set the blend mode to Multiply, Fractal type Turbulent Sharp, Noise type Linear. Contrast 640, brightness minus 54. Scale 50, complexity 6. Let's add an expression to the evolution. This time, posterize time, 8 in parentheses, semicolon, time asterisk 400. So we've set the frame rate to 8 frames per second and the evolution changes 400 degrees every second. We duplicate the layer and set the contrast to around 850. Scale back to 100. And in the expression, let's change 400 into 200. so it's bigger particles, but less. We duplicate it one more time and set the scale to around 450. Then we add an adjustment layer. Name it noise, and surprise, add noise. Amount 10%, no color noise though. Awesome, we're getting there. Then we add another black solid and name it vignette. And with the layer selected, we double click on the rounded rectangle tool. Open the mask property and set it to subtract. The feather to 300 pixels and the opacity to around 40%. We add another adjustment layer, name it brightness and contrast or BC. Then we add brightness and contrast. We add a random expression to brightness. Random minus 2.5 in parentheses. Then we copy it, we add an expression to the contrast property and paste it. Meaning values are randomly picked between minus 2 and 5, which creates this flicker. Awesome. Lots of things going on now, but we need to animate the text itself, right? Alright, we select the bottom title comp and add turbulent displace. Displacement turbulent, amount 4. Evolution, we add an expression, time asterisk 50. A subtle animation of the text. We need the other two title comps to move along. Therefore, we select the effect, copy it with property links, and paste it to the other two title comps. So whenever I change a value, the other two change along. Very convenient. Finally, we go to 5 frames. Select all three title comps, open the scale and position properties, and link the position and scale property of the two top comp layers to the bottom layer. And set keyframes. Also for the amount and size of the turbulent displace effect. Press U to see all the keyframes in the timeline, then go to 4 frames and set the amount to 50. The size to 400. The scale around 850. Position minus 260 and 400. At 3 frames, we set keyframes again, and we set the size to 420. At 2 frames, the amount 330. The position minus 780 and 370. The scale 250. At the beginning, the amount is 210. The position is minus 780 and 650. Awesome. We add one more adjustment layer, name it BC, adjust the endpoint, add brightness and contrast again, and set the brightness to 125. Contrast to 100. Minus 100. And let's add some exposure. Increase the exposure value, and let's decrease the gamma correction. These values are quite random. I figured them out for myself before recording this tutorial. I recommend playing around a little. It's a lot of fun and the results will be great. On the left side, I've added some videos you might like. Subscribe to my channel on the right side and hit the bell because you don't want to miss my next video. Thanks for watching this video. See you in the next one. Bye guys.